Here is NUCIDA's weekly forecast for the expected post activities in the realm of software quality on social media channels in week 32 of 2025. Our analysis is based on the social media post data from LinkedIn, YouTube, X, and other internet sources released last week, which revealed dynamic daily changes. I'll leverage the provided web results, which cover software quality trends for 2025, and combine them with logical extrapolation of ongoing conversations in the tech community. The ranking is based on the prominence of topics in recent publications, their relevance to current software quality challenges, and their engagement potential on the mentioned platforms. Each topic's ranking reflects its immediacy, impact, and discussion volume, with reasons for placement and a forecast for future trends included. So, what will be the top 10 hot topics this week? Buckle up and let's start the countdown. 10. Shift left testing, why it's ranked. 10. Shift left testing, where testing is integrated earlier in the development lifecycle, is gaining traction on platforms like social media due to its role in reducing defects and speeding up delivery. It's a steady topic, but it ranks lower because it's a mature concept with less novelty compared to others. Recent posts on social media highlight tools like Skase, Testem, and Catalon for enabling early testing, with blogs emphasizing their cost-saving potential for DevOps teams. My advice? Incorporate shift-left testing by embedding automated unit and integration tests in your CI/CD pipeline from the start. Use tools like Junit or Selenium to catch issues early. Collaborate closely with developers to define test cases during requirements gathering, ensuring quality is baked into the process rather than bolted on later. My forecast for 2025-2026. Shift left testing will remain relevant but evolve into shift everywhere approaches, with AI-driven test generation becoming standard. By 2026, expect tighter integration with low-code platforms, enabling non-technical stakeholders to contribute to early testing, further democratizing quality assurance. 9. Test automation for microservices, why it's ranked. Sure. 9. Microservices architectures are prevalent, and testing them is a growing concern. Blogs on sites like TechCrunch and discussions on social media highlight challenges in testing distributed systems, with tools like Postman, SOAP UI, and WireMock trending for API and microservice testing. It ranks lower due to its niche focus within broader automation trends. My advice? Invest in tools that support contract testing, e.g. PACT, and service virtualization to simulate microservices during testing. Ensure your test suites cover inter-service communication and failure scenarios, such as network latency or service downtime, to maintain reliability in distributed systems. My forecast for 2025-2026. As microservices adoption grows, especially in cloud-native environments, test automation for microservices will integrate with observability tools like Prometheus. By 2026, AI will likely predict microservice failure points, reducing manual test design and enhancing resilience. 8. Performance testing for scalability, why it's ranked. 8. With the rise of cloud and edge computing, performance testing to ensure scalability is a recurring topic. Social media posts mention tools like JMeter, NeoLoad, LoadRunner, LoadNinja, and Gatling, while blogs like Digital Trends discuss ensuring apps handle peak loads. It ranks mid-tier because it's critical, but less hyped than emerging tech like AI. My advice? Prioritize load and stress testing early in development using tools like LoadRunner or K6. Simulate real-world traffic spikes and monitor key metrics, e.g. response time, throughput, to identify bottlenecks. Integrate performance testing into your CI/CD pipeline to catch issues before deployment. My forecast for 2025-2026. Performance testing will grow in importance as 5G and IoT drive demand for ultra-low latency applications. By 2026, expect AI-driven performance testing tools to dynamically adjust test parameters based on real-time user data, optimizing scalability testing. 7. Security testing for zero trust, why it's ranked. GER7. The increasing frequency of cyber attacks has made zero trust security a hot topic. Blogs like Wired emphasize testing for vulnerabilities in a zero-trust model, while social media discussions highlight tools like OWASP Zap. It ranks higher due to its urgency, but is tempered by its overlap with broader cybersecurity trends. My advice? Adopt security testing tools like Burp Suite to scan for vulnerabilities and integrate them into your DevSecOps pipeline. Regularly test for OWASP top 10 vulnerabilities, such as SQL injection, and simulate real-world attack scenarios to validate zero-trust policies. My forecast for 2025-2026, zero-trust testing will become mandatory as regulations tighten. By 2026, AI-powered penetration testing tools will dominate, automating vulnerability detection and suggesting real-time mitigations, especially for cloud-based applications. 6. Accessibility testing, why it's ranked. 6. Accessibility in software is gaining attention due to legal mandates and social responsibility. Social media posts reference tools like Axe and Wave, while blogs like Mashable discuss inclusive design. It ranks mid-tier because it's a growing but not yet dominant focus compared to automation or AI. My advice, use automated accessibility testing tools like Lighthouse alongside manual testing to ensure compliance with WCAG standards. Involve users with disabilities in usability testing to catch real-world issues. Embed accessibility checks in your CI/CD pipeline to make inclusivity a default. My forecast for 2025-2026. Accessibility testing will surge as global regulations, e.g. ADA EU Accessibility Act, enforce stricter compliance. By 2026, AI tools will likely analyze user interfaces in real time to suggest accessibility improvements, making inclusive design more seamless. 5. Low-code, no-code testing challenges, why it's ranked. 5. The rise of low-code, no-code platforms, e.g. OutSystems, Mendix, has sparked discussions on social media and blogs like TechRadar about testing challenges in these environments. It ranks higher due to the growing adoption of these platforms, but is tempered by its emerging nature. My advice? Treat low-code platforms like traditional codebases for testing purposes. Use visual testing tools like AppleTools and AskUI to verify UI consistency and integrate automated tests for business logic. Train citizen developers on basic testing principles to maintain quality in low-code projects. My forecast for 2025-2026. As low-code, no-code adoption skyrockets, specialized testing frameworks for these platforms will emerge. By 2026, expect AI-driven tools to auto-generate tests for low-code apps, bridging the gap between citizen developers and professional QA teams. 4. Continuous testing in CI/CD pipelines. Why it's ranked. 4. Continuous testing is a cornerstone of modern DevOps, with social media posts and blogs like Ars Technica emphasizing its role in rapid delivery. Its high ranking reflects its widespread adoption and critical impact on software quality in agile environments. My advice? Integrate automated testing suites, e.g. Jenkins, GitLab CI, into your CI/CD pipeline to run tests at every commit. Balance unit, integration, and end-to-end tests to ensure comprehensive coverage. Monitor test results in real time to address failures quickly in test management tools, like TestRail, X-Ray, or Zephyr for further analysis. My forecast for 2025-2026, continuous testing will evolve with AI optimizing test prioritization and flagging redundant tests. By 2026, expect self-healing pipelines where AI automatically adjusts tests based on code changes, reducing maintenance overhead. 3. AI-driven test automation. Why it's ranked. 3. AI is transforming test automation, with tools like test.ai and Mabel trending on social media for their ability to generate and maintain tests. Blogs like VentureBeat highlight AI's role in reducing manual effort. It ranks high due to its disruptive potential and widespread buzz. My advice? Adopt AI-driven testing tools like AskUI to automate test case generation and maintenance, especially for complex applications. Combine AI with traditional tools to cover edge cases. regularly review AI-generated tests to ensure they align with business requirements and avoid over-reliance. My forecast for 2025-2026, AI-driven testing will dominate, with tools predicting defects before they occur by analyzing code patterns and user behavior. By 2026, expect generative AI to create entire test suites from natural language requirements, further reducing QA bottlenecks. 2. Quality engineering for AI/ML systems. Why it's ranked. Number 2. Testing AI/ML systems is a hot topic due to their complexity and ethical implications. Social media discussions focus on validating model accuracy and fairness, while blogs like The Verge explore biases in AI outputs. It ranks high due to the rapid growth of AI applications and public scrutiny. My advice: implement specialized testing for AI/ML, including data quality checks, model performance metrics, e.g., precision, recall, and bias detection. Use tools like TensorFlow model analysis to monitor models in production, or SCASE to evaluate the actual data quality. Engage diverse teams to test for ethical and fairness issues. My forecast for 2025-2026. As AI adoption accelerates, quality engineering for AI/ML will become a distinct discipline. By 2026, expect standardized frameworks for testing AI ethics and performance, with regulatory bodies mandating transparency in AI quality assurance. 1. Observability. Driven quality assurance, why it's ranked. 1. Observability, combining monitoring, logging, and tracing, is the top topic due to its critical role in ensuring software quality in production. Social media posts highlight tools like Grafana and Datadog, while blogs like TechCrunch emphasize real-time insights for proactive quality management. Its ranking reflects its holistic approach and alignment with cloud-native trends. My advice: implement observability tools to monitor application health, performance, and user experience in real time. Use distributed tracing, e.g. Jaeger, to pinpoint failures in complex systems. Correlate observability data with test results to proactively address quality issues before they impact users. My forecast for 2025-2026. Observability will become the backbone of quality assurance, with AI-driven tools predicting and preventing issues based on real-time data. By 2026, expect quality observability platforms that integrate testing, monitoring, and incident response into a unified workflow. My forecast for upcoming topics in 2025 and 2026. Looking ahead, several trends are poised to shape software quality discussions. Quantum computing testing. As quantum computing matures, testing quantum algorithms will emerge as a niche but growing topic. By 2026, expect blogs and social media posts to explore tools for simulating and validating quantum software, driven by advancements from companies like IBM and Google. Ethical AI testing. With increasing scrutiny on AI ethics, testing for fairness, transparency, and accountability will dominate. By 2026, regulatory frameworks will likely mandate ethical AI testing, boosting discussions on platforms like X. Zero-code testing platforms. The rise of no-code platforms will spur demand for zero-code testing tools, enabling non-technical users to create tests. Expect this to trend heavily in 2025 as citizen developers become more prevalent. Sustainability in software quality. Testing for energy efficiency and carbon footprint in software, e.g., green coding, will gain traction, especially in Europe, driven by environmental regulations. Blogs like Wired will likely cover this by mid-2025. Extended reality, XR testing. As AR, VR applications grow, testing for immersive experiences will become a hot topic. By 2026, expect specialized testing frameworks for XR discussed on tech blogs and social media. These topics reflect the intersection of technological innovation, regulatory pressures, and societal demands, ensuring software quality remains a dynamic field. Hopefully this video gives you additional insights. What do you think about the hot topics this week? Write your views in the comments section below. In terms of further questions, feel free to write to us. We will analyze all important internet channels and release our analysis report every Monday. Follow or subscribe to this channel to stay up to date and know more than your competitors. Happy testing, and see you next time.